Good to see you. Apologies, mate. But I don't have much to report. I can see bloody Nokron right above me. But I'm absolutely stumped. I've tried all the gateways, to no avail. Perhaps it's time to ask Celebes. I recall that spiteful little rat acting like he knew something. Let's give him a squeeze. Show him just how sharp my teeth are. I wouldn't go that far. Besides, I should cede this place to me. You just do what you feel is right. If either of us learns anything, we tell the other. Right? Leave this place to me. If either of us learns anything,
and if we reach
Celebes Red.
Well, well, you took me at my word. Did you not realize I was merely being polite? Oh, you provincials never cease to amaze. I suppose you're here now. Perhaps I'll give you something to do. I'd like you to find a woman called Nefeli to administer a potion. Even you can do that much, can't you? Good, good. Now I shall hand over the potion in question. Find Nefeli and ensure she drinks it. I expect glad tidings, and soon. I've no time for idle chit. The only thing I will hear from you is a report of your Tawi understood. I have enough on my plate. Well, well, you're asking me about that, are you? The task was left to you and the mongrel, was it not? Not only are you incompetent, but shameless to boot. Well, there's no helping it. Now's as good a time as any. I'll let you in on it. There's a glintstone sorcerer by the name of Selen in Limgrave. She owes me for the help I gave her when she was expelled from the academy. I asked her to look into the matter some time ago. I'll write you a letter of introduction. Go ask her. I've no time for idle. The only thing I will hear from you. Are we understood? I have enough on.
Yeah.
Young apprentice, first things first. You are a tadpole when it comes to magic. So, to become a sorcerer, first, you must face your... Now. Well, well. Celavus is not a name I ever wanted to hear again. But fine. If it will help you, my apprentice, I offer my knowledge. The stars alter the fate of the Carian royal family, and the fate of your mistress, Rani. But long ago, General Radahn challenged the swirling constellations, and in a crushing victory, arrested their cycles. Now he is the force that repulses the stars. If General Radahn were to die, the stars would resume their movement, and so too would Rani's destiny.
Well met. What news? So Rani's fate is kept in stasis by Starsgurz Radahn. That reminds me of something I heard. There's a festival being held at the castle on the southern edge of the Caelid Wilds, east of Limgrave. It's a festival of combat. And I heard that you can fight Radahn himself. He who's once called the strongest of all the demigods. Maybe it's just a coincidence. But I think it's worth investigating. I'll be on my way to this festival of Radahn then. You're coming too, right? To Radahn's festivities. I'll meet you at Redmayne Castle in Caelid. The way ahead is pleasingly simple. We fight, sword and fang. You're coming too, right? I'll meet you at Redmayne. The way ahead is pleasing. Players are all made up and waiting for the curtain. Let's give them a show to remember, eh? Just don't you go dying on me. For Rani's sake, too. Once more into the fray together.
Champions! Welcome! The stars have aligned! The festival is nigh! General Radahn, mightiest demigod of the Shattering, awaits you! Champions, prepare for battle! Defeat the general, claim glory, and grab that great rune! A celebration of war! Varadon Festival!
Are you good and prepared, young... The festival begins.
Before we begin, allow me to paint you the full picture. General Radahn is cursed ever to wander. Eaten from the inside by Melania's scarlet rot, his wits are long gone. Now he gathers the corpses of former friends and foes alike, gorging on them like a dog. Howling at the sky.
But now, we must make merry.
Oh, gathering of champions! The revels begin! The celebration of war! The Radahn Festival!
You will find the field of battle past the church ahead. Upon the shore under the fort, General Radahn is there, even now, divested of his wits, devouring corpses, and howling at the sky. You will find the field of General Radahn is divested of his and howling.
Thank you.
Ah, good. I was waiting for you. What a sick way to fight, eh? The glory of the clash is shared by Radahn and you. And did you see that afterwards? A falling star right before our eyes. I can't fathom how Radahn was holding back something of that scale. He was a living legend if ever I saw one. And the path has now been cleared. To Nokra, where Rani's fate will be decided. Let's meet where the falling star bit the earth. We'll take up our swords once more for Mistress Rani. Let's meet where the falling star bit the earth. My only purpose is to fight for Rani's fate, sword and fan. The curtain's rising on the final act. Let's meet where the fallen sun will go into battle. My only purpose is that the curtain's right. It's you. It's me, Blythe. Old E.G. trapped me here. Told me I'd bring naught but bail to Lady Rani. But there's no chance that could happen. I'm part of a being. A very shadow. I thought old E.G. knew as much. Honestly, I don't know what's going on anymore. My thanks, friend. I'm going to see Mistress Rani now. I don't know what came over old E.G., but even if the odds are slim, I need to check the mistress is safe. Now, Rani can finally set in motion the fight against her fate she's dreamt of for so long. I'm going to see Mistress Rani now, but even if the odds are slim,
finally come. Blythe told me everything. You've defeated General Radahn, unlocking the stars. The general was blighted by scarlet rot and driven to madness. But not long ago, he was hailed as the mightiest demigod of them all. There is no parallel to your achievement, nor to Lady Rani's acute judgment of character. Thanks to you, Lady Rani's fate once again stirs, and the path to Nokron has opened. Descend underground, where the fallen star struck Klimgrave, and make it yours. The precious treasure of Nokron. I presume you've spoken with Blythe? Very well. There is something you should know. The Two Fingers gave Blythe to Lady Rani as a faithful follower. Her very shadow, incapable of treachery. But if Lady Rani, as an Empyrean, resists being an instrument of the Two Fingers, the shadow will go mad, transforming from a follower into a horrid curse. But such is his destiny. In such matters, Blythe's own thoughts hold no weight. It pains me so. But he must be neutralized. For Lady Rani's sake.